Về tâm linh, hôm nay chúng tôi thật diễm phúc trình chiếu buổi hội thảo truyền hình đầy trí huệ mang tựa đề
Ngài Thanh Hải Vô Thượng Sư sáng tạo cõi giới tâm linh mới cho những người xứng đáng. Phần 2 trong 2 phần, trong tiết mục giữa thầy và trò được giảng bằng tiếng Anh vào ngày 19 tháng 12 năm 2018.
Master? In regards to the leftover food, we're wondering leftover food, how demons consume the food of humans after 9 minutes. So, Master, we're wondering if this also applies to beverages as well, like water, tea, or coffee?
Yeah. Yes. They don't eat your food. They just smell and inhale in the flavor to survive because they don't have the body, so they can survive on this flavor, okay?
Wow.
Ether body or astral body is the same like the smell. It doesn't have any substance, understand? But you can smell it, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah, like perfume. It is a liquid, but when you smell it, it's not a liquid or anything, but you can smell it. You don't put the perfume on your body, somebody else next to you do it, then you still can smell it and enjoy the smell.
Yes, Master.
Same with the people who drink alcohol and smoke. Many of the demon spirits, they have been alcoholic or smoker before. They love to hang around these kind of people. That's why it's more difficult for them to quit, not just because of the addiction or addictive substance, but also because of these demon spirits hanging around them, always encourage them to do more and help them with their energy, and then to continue to smoke or drink or gamble.
Yes, Master.
I have mentioned to you that the spirits of those demons who have been humans in a former life or lives, and they are still feeling addicted after they left the physical body and they are in the astral body.
Yes.
So they love to hang around the people who are alive and have a chance, have a body to enjoy the smoking.
Yes.
So they hang around so that they can inhale the smoke, just like the living person who enjoy this kind of cigarette or drug smoke and this kind of feeling and smelling and the intoxicating kind of effect. They hang around them and just keep pestering them invisibly to smoke more. And that's why the more they smoke, the more they want.
Mm. Wow.
And you've asked me, why is that somebody who smoke but doesn't have like cancer or doesn't have illnesses before they die?
Yes. Yes.
Nevertheless, their life will be cut short anyway because of these spirits hanging around them. Even more or less spirits depends on that person's merit in former lives or in this lifetime. In former lives, this person who smokes right now has a lot of merit and a good person, upright person. And even though he's smoking, the spirit, not many spirits are allowed to hang around next to him. Therefore, the influence of this so-called yin energy, meaning dark energy, negative energy, is not affecting him much. Therefore, he doesn't become sick or get those kind of unpleasant illness due to smoking or drug or alcohol. Okay?
Yes.
It's not just the alcohol or the drugs or the cigarettes alone that affecting a person. It is his own merit lacking or too weak, too feeble. Plus, have no faith in any master at all or never have seen a master so many lifetimes because of lack of meritorious substance, meritorious quality. So these kind of people who are lacking in meritorious quality are more prone to be influenced and abused by these addicted demons. You understand?
Yes,
very clear.
Therefore, he will get more sickness or cancer or other kind of bodily or mentally or psychologically affect because of too many demons hanging around him. If he is virtuous, more virtuous in the last lifetime or this lifetime, then the demon will be far distant from him. And they can inherit now and then or from far away, but not standing next to him, nearby him, in order to affect him with their own negative or low and hellish kind or astral kind of dark energy. Therefore, he still be able to be strong or live in a normal life.
Yes, Master.
These addicted persons, if they have very good merit or have strong faith in some higher beings, then they will be also have some sort of protection, more or less, depends on their merit or the faith. Also, even if they don't have enough merit to receive the protection from heavens or from angels, if their parents had enough or have enough merit, or their loved ones, someone that they love or love them, have enough merit, then can also share with him or her for the addicted person, then they also somehow get protected. That's why they don't get as tragically sick or die early like other addicted persons.
Yes, Master.
And or if these addicted people have a vegan or vegetarian diet, the merit of saving these lives of the animals would also help them to some degree to minimize the effect of the negative energy of the demons. And so maybe prolong their life, the life of these addicted people, or even preventing some of their disease, which they are supposed to have.
Yes, Master.
The same like the addicted people, are those people who are also addicted to meat or animals products, is the same situation. If they have a lot of merit to cover their meat consumption bad karma, then maybe they will survive good and it seems like they don't have any problem. But if they burn up all that or the good merit in their store by eating meat, or if their parents don't have merit or the loved ones don't have enough merit to share with that meat eater person, then they will also fall sick, fall ill, or die younger. A short life. Same thing.
Yes, Master.
If he has no virtues, and then he smokes as well, then many demons will hang around him. So much of the dark energies surrounding him all the time, every day, because he's smoking every day, or he gambles even. Many demons also addicted to gambling or alcohol. This kind of thing, they can always enjoy, you know, through the person who is having it, like drinking or smoking or drugging.
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
Even though they don't have the body, but if they hang on to that person very near or possess that person, possess that drinking or smoking or gambling person for temporarily while he is doing it, then they can enjoy just the same as if they have the body.
Yes, Master.
And if they keep taking turns to do that or do that at very short time together, like one demon spirit after another, then the smoking, drinking, or drugging, or gambling person is getting weaker and more addicted all the time, more and more. Therefore, the more they gamble, the more they want. The more they smoke, the more they continue to smoke more, and more heavily. That's the thing.
Yes.
And then because of too much negative energy hanging around him or her, they get weakened and the body lose the defense system.
Yes.
And become sick, gravely ill, and die. Short life. Shorter. Therefore, cigarette is not only harming people by their addictive substance, but also by attracting this kind of demons around the addicted person and harming him invisibly as well. So double harm. That's why cigarette, alcohol and gambling and drug and etc. is not advisable to anybody at all. Now you understand, okay?
Yes.
All right. And concerning the drink and all that, if you have a bottle of water, you pour out just as much as you can drink. And if the leftover, you just pour it outside or something for the demon to enjoy. Pour it slowly so they can have it. And you can leave a morsel or two after you finish your meal, leave it some, and then the demon can take it.
Yes, Master.
I leave some morsel or two when I eat. Sometimes I just leave it for a while and then I throw it out. And I invite them and say, okay, you can eat. You can think like that in your mind if you want.
Yes, Master.
Even drink tea and all that, you just pour out as much as you want. And don't leave it for a long time and then come back drink it, okay?
Yes,
after you sip it already, and you should finish it. Otherwise, don't drink it again afterward, after too long.
Yes,
you should know how much you want, like from food or from drink, you take as much as you want. If you want more, you take more. And whatever left in the thermos, whatever left in there or whatever left in your other bowl is still clean.
Yes.
It doesn't count as a leftover. But it would be better you eat whenever you eat it's fresh and you eat until you're satisfied, okay?
Yes, Master.
All right then. This is all complete answer now, I think, right?
Yes, thank you, Master.
Master, after an addict dies, do they also become a demon?
Yeah, if he doesn't have enough merit to continue to become a human again, he might be born as a demon or hungry ghost or addicted ghost or demon, same. Not all will be a demon. Even a person, if he smokes, but sometime during this lifetime, he do some good deed or somehow believe in some master or somehow helping with some good actions or having a good heart, then he will not be born as a ghost and he will be born accordingly, yeah, according to his karma.
Yes, Master.
But don't wait until then to find out. Maybe too late. It's very suffering to be a hungry ghost or addicted ghost and you don't have it to satisfy you. It's worse than a person who is addicted when he is still alive. It's uncontrollable because that person don't have a body when he die and he's addicted, a ghost, and he has no control. He has no body to even try to forget. Everything is clear to him. To be a ghost and demons is very suffering type of life. Especially if a hungry ghost or addicted ghost.
Yes, Master.
One more important thing. Why is the person, for example, a person who smoke and get like throat cancer or lung cancer or whatever cancer in his body? Do you know why?
No, Master.
Okay. They all blame it on the substance of the cigarette. But then why somebody else who smoke all their life and don't get that? You see what I mean?
Understand, Master.
It's because these demons, they abuse these smokers, whoever that is, she or he. And the smoker only wants a maximum how much per day. Yet the demons come more and more because this person don't have enough merit to have protection from the angels. Therefore, the demons come and come more and more, and then they demand more. And when that smoker don't satisfy them, and then the demons get angry. And then they try to scratch into his throat or suck into the smoker's throat in order to find leftover some of the taste and some of the substance of the smoke of the cigarette is still there. They try to scratch, to dig into their stomach or their liver, their lungs, or their throat because the substance of the cigarette or the drug are still in there.
Yes, Master.
Therefore, that person, so many demons digging into his lung, digging into his throat, or his stomach, his liver, etc., to find out the leftover substance to satisfy themselves. Then, how can that person survive?
Understood.
Imagine.
Understood.
Yeah? That's why they have cancer as well, not just the substance of the drug or the cigarette. And the same with the addicted of gambling because of many demons surrounding them. And if those persons who gamble do not have enough merit to be protected by angel or to be protected by their own merit or virtue, then more demons will come and demand to possess this body, taking turn or together in order to make that person gamble more for the demon's satisfaction.
Wow.
That is why. That is why the gambler is difficult to quit. That's why the smoker difficult to quit and get sick, cancer here and there. Apart from the substance as inherent in the cigarette or the drug that make them sick as well, and the demons make it worse. That is very fearful thing. If the people who smoke or taking drug, the abusive drug, know that and they can see it, then they would be so fearful. They would never want to even look at those drugs or any of these addictive substances.
Yes, Master.
I have another question. Master, every time your poem airs, the real heroes about the two Korean leaders, it's so inspiring and moving, and it just shows that Master is truly bringing peace to earth through the world leaders, and it shows that some of these leaders are, as Master said, bodhisattvas, and they must have come down to help. So I was wondering, could Master reveal her past affinity, if any, with the two Korean leaders and the Korean people?
Okay. I haven't checked on that, but just wait a moment if I can check it now, okay?
Thank you, Master.
If I cannot check it now, then I will tell you another time when our conference again, okay?
Yes, Master.
Sorry, I don't have enough time now. Maybe next time, okay?
Yes, Master.
I will remember your question. I will answer it, okay? When I have time to meditate on it, okay?
Thank you, Master.
That's all the questions we have, Master.
Okay. All right, then... I wish I have another meat to satisfy everybody's needs. That at the moment is kind of not that easy. All right, then I wish you a good night and have a lovely dream, a heavenly vision, and fit and well for tomorrow marathon again.
Thank you, Master.
Yeah. We are all in it together. Me also, I work also hard. You know, right?
Yes, I hope you do.
Yes, Master.
If you're next to me and seeing me working, I feel like Master work like an ant, you know, or bee. Oh. Because, you know, very, very busy, and you will wonder how anybody can do that.
Yes, Master.
I wonder it myself, so don't ask me. I don't have an answer, okay, for that. All right. It's many things I have to do, but I can't always tell you because time limit, and also sometimes you don't have to know.
Yes.
But one thing that I always have enough inside power to protect you and love you, okay?
Thank you so much, Master.
So you feel secured.
Yes.
Whatever you do, be unconditional. Don't forget that.
Yes, Master.
That's the only way that you should live your life. Unconditional love, okay? Unconditional dedication. Unconditional service. Okay?
Yes, Master.
All right. God bless. God bless. God bless. God love. Heaven protect. And I love you.
We love you, Master.